All right, Sonia.
Yes.
So I wanted you to share some spinning principle that I can share with the my salsa audience.
All
So
right.
what do you recommend? What are the good practices of a good spin?
Perfect. So because you're doing salsa, we're going to do the parallel turn. Because the parallel turn is the one you'll use the most, I believe, because of the fact that you have a partner. You won't be like this because, or else you're going to hit him all the time. So, options that you have just for the passe is you can have it here or you can have it here. Wherever that leg is, you want to make sure that it's holding itself. If it's hooked onto the other, that's too much weight for that leg and you won't be able to turn properly. So, you want to push in this leg and have this one completely relaxed and holding itself. The prep is really important. In jazz, we prep here, but because you'd have a partner, you'd have to just drop, which is the actual beginning of the turn, okay? The more I drop, especially if I go to the side, I'll show you. If I'm here, this is the amount of push I get. If I bend my knees for real, then I get a lot of power to turn from. Now, the most important thing is not the power, but the speed at which I come to this actual preparation. If the power is too much, I'm going to throw myself off my center. If I just have speed, it's going to give me the speed at which my turn can happen. So, what do I mean by that? One, the most essential thing is your spot. If I want to make sure that I come back to the same place, I have to make sure that I'm looking at my head. My head stays parallel to the floor, and then my head will whip through before the rest of my body comes through. So if I do that again, I hold, I hold, I hold, my head stays parallel, whip the head again, and then come through. This is not something you're going to work in the studio. So what I do is tell my students, you look for something really big. For example, something that has a lot of lettering or something that stands out. So here, I would look for the white lettering in this poster, and all I would do is focus, turn, 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 let my eyes fall back on the white letters without actually trying to stop on a particular point. I just want my head to develop the reflex of coming back before the rest of my body. That is number one. No spot, no turn. Because then we get really dizzy and the liquid in our ears gets unbalanced, and that's why we can't keep going, okay? So, one spot. The second thing that's essential is the actual bend to push. So, the lower I am, the more I'm gonna have speed to lift here. So, I wanna come down, and from that drop, I wanna push through. That's what I'm looking to do, just for my center. Now, you can turn on a straight leg or a bent knee, but if I'm gonna bend my knee, it has to be fully bent. Not just from here, I can't have a released knee. It has to be or bent or stretched, one or the other, all right? Then the number of spins will depend on how quickly I can get to this position. One of the big mistakes people make is what we call the wind-up. And then they go, and I'm gonna turn. If I start from this position, nothing is lined up, so I won't be able to stop it in midair, and I'm gonna keep on twisting, and therefore I won't be able to hold the position. So you wanna stay here, and the only thing I wanna do is wrap this arm and get me in. So that's what I'm looking for, to be able to turn the head. Make sure that I'm really nice and high and this leg is relaxed. When I go up, we are not birds. And everybody goes, "I'm gonna go up." No, I want to imagine that if my leg was a screwdriver, I'm screwing the end of my foot into the ground. So I don't want to go up, I want to push down. And that's how I stay there and I can keep turning and turning and turning and having a conversation with you. Right? So those are the things. One, spot. Two, bend and make sure you wrap really quickly, but don't twist. Wrap. Right? Three, once you turn, just keep on turning and do not drop that leg until you actually come back to the front. And four, push down. Don't lift. Yes? If they do that and you practice on a regular basis, most of my students they do it 2 or 3 times a week. Within 2 or 3 months, they're doing double pirouettes, so double turns. nice and solid on both sides.
All right, Sonia, thank you very much. Just let everybody know where they can find you.
All right, so for professionals, for young dancers between 17 and 25 who want to become professional dancers, you can find us at www.endc.ca. As of December 1st, we are opening up admissions and all auditions will be in February 25th and 26th. Hope to see you there.
All right.